Hi friends, this is Priyannth from team EBAD. It was exactly 6 months back. In a sufficiently lit room in our campus, my fellow classmates were doing experiments on ECG and cardio tachometer. That's when I wondered how simple the idea was to use ECG to diagnose heart-related diseases with just observing a minor variation in ECG. That's when I also wondered, why don't we use ECG for biometric authentication devices? That's where all the deliberations about EBAD started. The ECG waveforms of my fellow classmates were obtained with their consent, and we calculated the peak amplitudes of P, R and T waves in ECG waveform. To our surprise, the fiducial ratios were calculated from those amplitudes, such as P by R, R by T and P by T, were found to be unique for the subject that we considered and motivated us to produce EBAD as a proof of concept. The components such as ADS-1298 ECG FE demonstration kit and the Beagle-Bone Black microcontroller can be used accordingly to calculate the fiducial ratios from the acquired ECG signal.
Electrode placement as per lead one configuration is made where electrodes are stuck onto the left arm and the right arm with right leg as reference. The lead wire connecting the electrodes to the ADS-1298 ECG FEPDK is then employed, which has a 15-pin configuration. This is followed by connecting the evaluation module to the PC where the ADS-1298 EVM software recognizes the module. Once the message sync complete ready is displayed, the channel control resistors of channels 2, 3 and 8 corresponding to the left arm and right leg are set to normal electrode mode, whereas all the other unused channels resistors are set to input short mode. The display tab of the software is then chosen under which ECG display tab is selected. Here, in order to filter out noise signals, low pass filter is enabled, setting the cutoff frequency to 18 Hz with a filter order of 3. Then the ECG is recorded in the continuous mode in order to have a greater set of ECG data. The lead one scope is then chosen where the peak amplitudes of P, R and T waves of the ECG are noted down for each subject to calculate the fiducial ratios of P by R, R by T and P by T. For a sample set of 65 subjects, the intervariability was prevented and intravariability was within the permissible limits of 0.1%, confirming the biometric authentication ability of ECG.
My name is Pasupathy Rajan. I am working at the staff of the SASTRA University School of Mechanical Engineering. My age is 51.
I would like to know your viewpoints on existing biometric authentication devices, like your fingerprint scanners as well.
I know that some incidents I came to know that they are misusing these fingerprints.
How, sir?
Some criminalizing this one, for doing some things. It is not seems to be reliable. So it is better to go for something innovative, ideas,
alternative
so that we can have reliability on this biometric system, particularly in the case of military and all safety systems.
Yes.
So it is a very good idea. So how far it is significant compared with these fingerprints?
Sir, that is a very good point that you have raised, sir. So considering our ECG, it is an inherent and dynamic signal, a biosignal, which can be derived only from a live and legitimate source. The second advantage is that it is highly robust, that is, your ECG is always available with you.
So the EGC system of fingerprint authentication, replacing this with the ECG authentication, other than that all the companies or organization will accept this one.
The major driving force behind them accepting our product is the price that we are setting for this device. We are making sure that these are devices which comes under the disruptive technology category, has the same market value as that of a fingerprint scanner.
I understand well.
Thank you, sir.
I appreciate this type of innovative and creative type of designs. If this is successful in future, I will be very happy.
Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot, sir. Now we'll be demonstrating the prototype for you, sir. Thank you, sir.